Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next topic. That is, in the last lecture, so we started the discussion about paging, right? And I raised two disadvantages with respect to paging. I told that the paging is really slow, and I also informed that there is a chance of internal fragmentation still. So how you can resolve these two issues up to some extent, we'll be discussing in this lecture, guys. Okay, so as the speed is reduced by half, so this is the first issue which we will be taking care. So here, to resolve this particular thing, we are going to add a new structure, guys. So this is called as a TLB. Okay, so TLB is nothing but trans look ahead buffer, guys. Okay, so it's correct only, right? I did not write the full form. That's really good, right? Okay, so it's a trans look ahead buffer only, I think so. Okay, yes, okay. So basically, this is a hardware component, guys, which we are going to add in between. So basically, before going into page table, we are going to send our data to this. So basically, it is going to check here whether the particular page which we are searching is already in it. So it is something like a cache, you can say, in simple words. So it will be really small, and it is going to store a very few pages and frames. So basically, if operating system wants it, so we will be using it, guys, because we want fastness, right? So previously I told this access will take main memory size time, and this access will also take main memory time. So basically at that time it is taking 2 memory time, right? But when it comes to now, as it is a hardware component, so here there will be no time, and the only time which we take is main memory, and which is really good, right? So already we have multiplied the speed, or we have divided the speed, right? Yes, so we have reduced that time. So in half time we can reach. So previously if we are reaching at 30 minutes, so now we can reach in 15 minutes. Got it? Yes. So basically it will be nanoseconds or milliseconds. Sorry for my comparison. Okay. Yes. So now let us go through the theory, and we will be taking a small problem so that you will understand. So as a speed is, so a serious problem with the paging is a translation process is slower as page table is accessed 2 times. So it is a 2mm. So one of the page table and the other for actual access, right? Yes. So to resolve this problem in paging, we take the help of TLB. That is nothing but trans look ahead buffer. So the TLB is associative high speed memory. Okay, so it's going to be really fast, and the reason why it is ultra fast is because it is a hardware component, guys. Okay, hence only limited entries will be there. So it is not a particular storage or something that you can change or that you can build on your own. So it is a hardware component which will be fixed in your system. So that many only will be available. Okay, so frequently or recently used records are stored. So basically assume that you are running a particular program. So if you are running a particular program, so again and again the CPU will request for the next line, right? So at that time assume that each and every program is of part P1. Okay, so P1 is having 1000 lines. Okay, so at that time 1000 times it is going to request for the next line, right? So if you are storing that P1 here, and assume that is stored at A address, so at that time it will be automatically mapped, and you will get directly the result really fast, right? So only first time it will go to the here, and it will get the data, and it will store here. Okay, so if it is found here directly, we call it as a hit, guys. And if it did not hit here, so you will go here and you will find. So that is nothing but TLB miss. So this is a TLB hit, and this is a TLB miss. Okay, so for easy understanding, I'll be directly taking you through a problem, guys. Okay, yes. So this is a question which is given, I think it will say gate PYQP. Okay, so these problems are really easy, guys. The only thing is, if you understood the concept of TLB, you can solve it in within minutes, and you can get 1 or 2 marks based on the question. Okay, yes. So they are saying the hit ratio is 90%, guys. They are saying 90% of the time, if you request for any page, you are going to find the frame number easily. Okay, so that is a 90% of the time. So that is a hit. They are saying the main memory access time is 100 milliseconds. Okay, and they are saying the TLB access time is 10 nanoseconds. So now you are getting the idea, right? So how much small it is, guys? Yes. Okay, yes. So it is nothing. So if you want more clarity, it is 100 into 10 power minus 3 second, whereas this is 100 into 10 power minus 9 seconds, guys. So now you are understanding, right? So it is 1 by 10 power 6 times slow, faster it is, right? Yes. Okay, so now let us understand. So now what we do is, so let us try the traditional method. So if it is the traditional paging, so what will happen? It will take 2mm time. That is nothing but it will take 200 milliseconds to get the data, right? Yes. So now as we are using TLB here. So now the formula will be reduced by a bit, guys. So assume that we are going to hit the particular request. So if we are hitting the particular request, how much time, how much chance is there, guys? So 0.9%, it is a hit, and 0.9, and if it is a miss, it is a 0.1 chance, right? Yes, out of 1 I am talking. Okay, so hit is this much and miss is this much. So if it hits, so it will take TLB time plus main memory time, right? Yes. But if it misses, so it is nothing but miss into TLB time plus again you need to search in your page table, right? Yes. Along with, after that you need to access the data. So indirectly here there will be a penalty of TLB, right? Yes. So hit is how much, guys? I told it is 0.9 into TLB. The value for TLB is 10 plus this MM is 100. Okay. Plus the miss ratio is 0.1. So few books they will write it as a 1 minus hit, guys. So it is nothing but the same miss ratio only. So it is a TLB. So the value of TLB is 10. This is 100. This is 100. Okay. So for easy understanding, rather than again converting these things and calculating, I am assuming this as a nanoseconds directly. Okay. So assume that both of them are nanoseconds. Okay. Yes. So at that time, what will be the case, guys? It becomes 0.9 into 110. Plus 0.1 into 210. So the final result will be 120 nanoseconds, guys. So even with nanoseconds thing, so you can clearly say that this is really, really fast than this, right? Yes. So if you take the original value, like this is milliseconds, it will be way faster, guys. Okay. Yes. So now you got the idea, right? So how exactly we are solving this? Yes. So there are around 5 to 10 questions in the last few years of PYQ business. So you can understand the importance of this particular topic by itself, right? Yes. Okay. So now you got the idea. Okay. Yes. So what does a TLB do, guys? So TLB is going to help you resolve the speed problem, right? Yes. So even the TLB, even we can divide into OS. Okay. So even in TLB, even we can divide. Okay. So let that statement be in that way only. Okay. Yes. So there are some more examples in the book, guys. If you want, you can directly check them. So the same concept, guys. They will give hit ratio. They will say you how much time it is taking to check in TLB, how much time it is going to take in main memory. So the same concept they will give and they will ask you the questions. Okay. So now you got the idea how you are going to resolve the speed issue, right? Yes. So now let us go through the second issue, that is internal fragmentation, guys. So what is internal fragmentation? So if you recall, in our example, we gave 1 KB slot for the frame and page, right? So for both of them, we gave exactly 1 KB. The issue here is, so if a particular processor, if a particular program, or if a particular part needs only 1 byte of data, so at that time, indirectly, the rest of whole space is wasted, right? So this is nothing but internal fragmentation. So a good solution for this will be, so why are you taking 1 KB? Make it 1 byte. So if your system is a byte addressable, so make it 1 byte. So make it into 1024 pieces rather than this 1 piece. So that could be a best approach. But how many things will you store, guys? So for each and every one, you will give a page number, that all things will be there, right? Yes. So that is the thing. So a common solution is, so if you think that you are wasting a lot of space, just make your page size into half, guys. So basically, instead of 1 KB, use 512 bytes for both the page and frame. Okay, so that's what it's written here. So if 1 byte process come, rest space is under internal fragmentation, right? So the same example I have taken here. So note, internal fragmentation occurs in last page only. So assume that if you are having a program which is of 210 KB, okay, plus 1 byte. So basically this 1 byte is also there in it. So assume in this way. So basically the first 210 slots will not have any issue, right? So the last, this extra 1 byte will only have that issue, because that 1 byte is going to waste the rest of the slots there, right? So rest of the spots in its own slot, right? Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay, so now what they say is, so a funny idea could be to reduce the page size to 512, then number of pages will be doubled and internal fragmentation will reduce. But if you do it in that way, so at the end, you are going to reduce the internal fragmentation, but the page table size will also increase in the opposite way, right? Because you are going to make more and more things. So basically, if you recall, in our example, we gave 1 GB for 8. So as you recall it, guys, so we are having 8 GB of main memory. I told let us make 11 GB, so we got 8 slots. So our page table will need at least at max 8, right? Yes. But if I make it into half, so now it will be 16, so automatically the page table will also increase. The internal fragmentation might decrease, but the page will increase, right? So that is a disadvantage here. Right? Yes. So that is what we have drawn here, and the best spot is the exact point, guys. Okay, so as a page size increases, the page table size decreases, right? Yes, because the page table size, if it is increasing, the size will increase, right? So from 512 MB, if I come to 1 GB, what will happen, guys? It is going to increase, right? Yes, so as it is increasing, the page table slots from 16, it will move to 8. So indirectly, the page table size will reduce, but the chance of internal fragmentation. So in this 1 GB, if a small program of 1 byte comes, oh my God, indirectly almost 1 GB of slot is wasted, right? So that is the disadvantage here. So that is the reason why some idle case they will be taking, guys. Okay, so they don't want more number of pages and they don't want more internal fragmentation. So at some middle point, they're gonna compromise with it. Okay, yes. So this is the second solution for internal fragmentation. Okay, yes. So now I hope everyone got some, at least some basic idea of how you can solve these two problems, right? So the problem with respect to that and problem with respect to this. So the problem of internal fragmentation is reduced with this understanding only. They are going to take an ideal case in between, and the problem for the two memory access will also be resolved with that TLB only. So in real time today, we are using this TLB concept to reduce it. Okay, yes. And to be clear, I want to be clear with you guys. So to be clear, we are not using only traditional paging in our systems, guys. So we are going to use a multi-level paging with the segmentation or some kind of pattern in that way. Okay, yes. So that is the reason why we'll be discussing about multi-paging and its hierarchy in the next lecture, guys. Okay, so the next 3 lectures will be really short, guys. So I don't know whether I'll be covering all the 3 in a single lecture or I'll be making different lectures for them. So in the next lecture, we'll be discussing a multi-level paging. After that, we'll discuss segmentation. After that, we'll discuss segmentation with paging. So these concepts are really small and interesting. Okay, yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to paging now. So in the next lecture, we'll be moving on with the multi-level paging. Okay, yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.